Good day, people of God. It's Erica Danielle, and it's Monday, so I just wanted to give you guys a quick word, hopefully quick, for you guys to think on, to muse on, and stand on throughout the rest of the week. Now, this word, it's a word of encouragement, but I just want you, I'm just going to read the scripture, and then you guys, then we'll go from there. So the scripture that I'm going to read is John chapter 8, verse 44. I'm going to read the verse in its entirety, but there's a certain part I want to highlight. Okay, it says, ye are of your father, the devil, and the lust of your father ye will do. He was a murderer from the beginning and abode not in the truth because there is no truth in him. That is what I want to highlight on. He abode not in the truth because there is no truth in him. So when we think about that and we think about the world that we operate in, right? The word tells us that Satan is the god of this world. He's the god of the airways. You know, we know everything that we're, you know, everything that is presented to us for the most part is generally not of God. The things that we're seeing on TV, the kind of music that, you know, we're listening to, the things that we're looking at on our phone, the things that we're reading, it is on us to make a conscious effort to make sure that we are finding things to watch, to listen to read, stuff like that that aligns with God's word, because for the most part, that's not just what's put out there in front of us or for us to, you know, to entertain us or whatever, right? So what I'm saying is, because I think I said this before in another video, it's so important for us as believers and for us that are walking in truth, that are trying to align our lives with the Most High and with His Word, to not only, the most important thing, obviously, is replenishing and feasting on His Word daily, because we're constantly being bombarded with lies. And the reason why I say lies is because the word just told us that the truth is not in Satan, and he's our enemy. And we know that we wrestle not against flesh and blood. We're wrestling, we're in spiritual warfare all the time, right? So it doesn't just come in the way of, you know, a one-on-one thing, maybe a person that you're dealing with, maybe your boss or your coworker or one of your friends turns on you. It does come that way, but that's not the only way that it comes. The war is against our mind. So it's coming, like I said, the stuff that we're watching on TV, the things we're looking at on our phone, the things that we're reading, the music that we're listening to. All of that is a war on our spirit. All of that is a war on our mind. So we have to make the effort to make sure that we are replenishing ourselves with truth daily. And the truth is the word of Yah. So you have to be walking with him. You have to be in his word, because his word is full of the truth. You have to be able to go in there and look for scriptures and, you know, find things that you need to stand on. And I'm saying that, you know, when we're going through, because we all go through different situations in life. I talk about this all the time, because it's life. We're all constantly going through something in life, you know. And sometimes you may have to Google something. I need to find a scripture on a broken heart, or, you know, what does the Bible say about, I mean, anything, whatever it is that you're dealing with. And then you find those scriptures, you study those things out, go into prayer, ask God to lead you, ask the Holy Spirit to guide you to the right scripture. He'll guide you to the book that you need to go to. He'll guide you to the chapter, the verse that you need to go to. And that is how you replenish yourself with the truth. If there's nothing in particular that you're looking for, get in the word. Get in the word. Ask him, what does he want you to read? What should you be focusing on? If maybe you're feeling like you're not getting a direct answer, because that does happen sometimes, pick a book. You can't go wrong with the word. And the importance is, or the main thing is we just have to replenish ourselves daily. We must replenish ourselves daily with the word of Yahuah, because the word of Yahuah is the truth. And when we're constantly being bombarded with lies, what happens is, and there's nothing counteracting that, what happens is we begin to believe the lies, and then we begin to operate out of that belief. You know, the word says that faith comes by hearing. That means whether you're hearing the word of Yahuah or you're hearing lies, whatever you're hearing repeatedly, you begin to have faith for that. Meaning basically you just begin to believe that. And once you start believing something, that's what your actions are going to follow, what you believe. You know, so it's just a quick word to remind you, and really just to highlight the importance of replenishing yourself with the word of Yahuah daily to counteract the lies that we are all bombarded with daily. Make sure that you get that time alone. And I know all of us have, you know, different schedules. And again, all of us are on different, we're at different levels of our walk. So for some people, maybe you're really, really busy. And I understand that. It's, for some people, you may not know where to begin. I understand that as well. So what you do is carve out a bare minimum. Carve out 10 minutes a day. Whether it's before you get your day started, whether it's before you, you know, when you finally get some time, your kids are asleep, whatever, carve out 10 minutes a day and tell the Most High, this is my time I'm dedicating to you, because I really am trying to put forth an effort. I really want to learn you. I really want to grow in your word. I really want to grow in your truth. You know, and you start doing that, and then you watch how the Most High increases you. And I'm not talking about with tangible blessings. I'm just talking about how he starts to increase you spiritually, how he starts to strengthen you spiritually. Because again, we are in war, whether we choose to acknowledge it or not. We are in an active war, and you cannot war properly when you're fatigued, when you're hungry, when you're weak. You wouldn't do it in your natural sense. You know what I mean? You're not gonna put, or a military would not put a weak, hungry, fatigued, starving soldier on the front lines to fight for his country and fight for the lives of the people around him. We gotta have the same mindset. You have to feed your spirit, man. You have to feed your inner spirit. So you have to make the effort. You have to carve out the time. So that is the word. And let me give you the scripture again. It's John 8:44. And the bottom line is, when it comes to Satan, who is our spiritual enemy, there's no truth in him. That means every time Satan speaks a word to you, every time he puts a thought in your mind, it's a lie. It's a lie from the pit of hell. The Bible says that there is no truth in him. So whatever he's saying is a lie. So we have to begin to, and the more you spend time with the Most High, the more you'll begin to, you know, get comfortable with this and know what to, you know a little bit more to do or how to counteract these things. But you have to, at least a bare minimum, and start casting those thoughts down when those things come up. I know this is kind of all over the place because I wasn't speaking about Satan speaking to you, but what I'm saying is he's the God of this world. So we have to be careful with what you're watching, be careful with what you're reading, be careful with what you're listening to. Replenish yourself in the word daily. You have to counteract the lies with the truth of Yahuah. Make sure that you are getting your time in. Make sure that you're sitting at the feet of Yah. Make sure you are seeking him. And that's it for today. So I hope this blesses you. And I hope you have an amazing rest of the week. And, you know, Yahuah willing, I will be here Wednesday to give you guys a word of encouragement. But be blessed.